and put that dress away, Rose?
Are we not attending the ball this evening?
Here we are. But I shall wear the white and silver instead. And my hair, will you do it just the way you like, with the circlet of jewels and flowers?
Of course. You look perfect.
Good. That is what they want.
The bride undoubtedly is giddy with anticipation over the impending nuptials.
Well, I shall need fittings for the dress.
And my trousseau.
And, oh, I'm forgetting something, surely, Rose.
I shall take care of everything, miss. Just think, she'll be the Duchess by Saturday.
Your mistress will not know the household staff at the Duke's country home, so it will be your business to attend to her needs and ease her arrival. Her happiness is your greatest concern.
No, no, no. The icing must be as white as lilies. This is a proper family.
A shipment of fine sugar went down at sea. There is no more to be had in London for love, no money.
Does Miss Daphne wish for roses or lilacs for the ceremony?
Does your mistress wish the cake to be soaked in rum or brandy?
Will it be tongue or ham with eggs for the reception?
I am not sure. I shall ask.
Rose, you are the future Duchess's lady's maid. You must know these things.
Miss?
Rose.
Is everything all right?
I cannot sleep. It is quite late for you to be up too, is it not?
There's much to be done. If you're nervous about the wedding, you need not worry. I assure you, I'm managing everything. I will be ready.
I know you will. You are not who I worry about. The Duke.
Has he asked to beg off, miss?
No. He may wish to.
Every man entertains doubt before the day, I rather think. But it does not signify. He will be a good husband to you. A good father as well. Miss?
He cannot have children. I shall not pretend to understand the extent of his physical impediment, but I imagine it is a source of great pain for the Duke indeed.
I have an aunt. She lives in Greenwich with her husband. They've been married for 10 years now. And never blessed with children, but they still are to each other as husband and wife. Theirs is a happy union.
Because they love each other. At least your aunt has that. I shall not keep you, Rose. You must have 100 things to do.
Of course, miss. Good night. Apologies, Your Grace.
Well, our activities are quite spirited. I admit, I did not even know it was possible. I believed his physical inability to have children would preclude him from
causing such difficult entanglements.
Yes. I'm quite glad to say I was wrong.
Missing home, Your Grace?
Do you think we have enough for all the baskets?
I should think so.
Your Grace! Whatever! I will have someone gather those on your behalf, one of the kitchen maids or the gardener. There's no one available to assist you.
Oh, there is no need to trouble anyone, Mrs. Colson. We have it all in hand.
Do you intend to collect honey from the hives in person as well?
That might be a little beyond me. Thank you, Mrs. Colson. Faith, she despises me.
She despises everybody. Do not give it another thought.
What is wrong? You should have rung for me.
I need you to tell me something, Rose. How does a woman come to be with child?
Your mother...
No, my mother told me nothing. Please, no embarrassment. Explain it to me, precisely.
The town has been desperate for you since you returned. We've been drowning in calling cards. Oh, Lady Danbury requires your attendance at her party on Thursday.
A collection of married ladies. I can only imagine the questions they will have for me.
I shall inform her footman that you are not feeling well from the travel.
Your Grace.
Your Grace.
Do you suppose the General's wife will be in attendance at Lady Danbury's soiree?
Mrs. Langham? I heard she enjoys society.
Then send word back. I would love to attend.